This is Sister Helen Prejean, and this is Questions for Sister Helen. Anytime you face a challenge, like I did, I had never been anywhere near death row or near the death penalty. So first, it was a big learning curve. I really had to get real knowledge about what was going on so I didn't just speak out of emotion. So that's always one of the first things that you have to deal with. What's going on here? I've never been exposed to it before. I got to get knowledge. And when we have knowledge of something, especially when we see the injustice of it, that's when the passion kicks in. But you can't just go on emotion. My Catholic faith, Christ is an adventure. And Christ unfolds inside of us. I went from being a nun, a Catholic nun, and I still am, that just thought if I practiced charity to those around me, that would be following Jesus. And then I awakened, and grace wakes us up. I awakened to the whole thing of justice. And that led me to leave my comfortable neighborhood and go and live among African American people who became my teachers. And then I launched into a whole other dimension of service to people that was rooted in justice. And that's the gospel of Jesus. As Pope Francis always says, he was over with the marginated. And as Pope Francis tells us, following Christ is that we got to be like field hospitals out where the wounded people of society are. My favorite quote in the scriptures is from Jesus, "I've come that you may have life to the full." To really be alive. It's all about life. Sometimes religion can be cast as duty or even worse, fear of being punished. But it's about really living and being alive. That, to me, is my favorite quote in the scriptures. It's in the Gospel of John, chapter 10. Sneaky Jesus got me involved. I didn't know. I had no idea that I was going to end up with people executed. I thought I was only going to be writing letters, and that came from an invitation. The basic scripture story that speaks to me is the Annunciation. You get invitations to do stuff. So the invitation came to be a pen pal, and then I went to visit him, and lo and behold, I'm with him when he's executed, and that changed my whole life because I became a witness to a very secret or semi-secret ritual of death. And so I have to tell that story. And that's what brings me actually to DePaul. Meeting the people, that's the best about DePaul. There's such a warmth here, people, in people. And they got such a good diversity. I love meeting the students. Love being with the faculty. The faculty are real people, really making this school go. And I love the Vincentian spirit. It's getting there where you make a difference. And imagine what Vincent was faced with. And he just says, what needs to be done? So after I came out of that execution chamber, you know, it's with that first man who was executed. I just went, what are we going to do? I had vomited. I threw up after seeing a human being killed. But what can one person do in the face of all that? And everybody in that cat was for the death penalty in Louisiana in 1994. So what can you do? Well, the first thing you can do is just be true to start talking to people and sharing honestly what you've seen, what you've learned, and what you believe. There are a number of ways I recharge. I do have a really good sense of humor. I recharge through humor a lot. I cultivate humor. The basic recharging is the quiet time, sit in prayer with Christ. And I learned this in prayer a long time ago. It's one of the things St. Ignatius said, where he said, just talk to Christ in your own words as you would talk to a friend. And just talk it over. So that I can be attuned to when I'm tired, when I need sleep, when I need a nap, and trying to follow discernment in my life of where God's moving. and being alert to what brings me joy, what makes me sad, and things like that in meditation. Involved in the making of the film of Deme Walking, and you have in the archives the actual first script screenplay that Tim Robbins wrote and my notes on the side, and they built the set of the holding cell and then where the execution chamber was. And I walked on that set and I couldn't believe how they had gotten it exactly the way it was in Louisiana. And so we went through that, and you know, it is hard work to make a film. They do it over and over and over, very intense scenes. And so I loved working with them, and then really just entrusted that this film, I didn't have many hopes at all when we did the film that it would do any good. The support for the death penalty was so overwhelming in the country. So it was just really great to be a part. Every single line that's in that movie, we worked in together, and they kept pestering me to do a cameo. So for peace, finally, I did this little cameo scene outside the gates of the prison. But it was great to work with all of them. Everybody on the set was reading the book of Deme Walking. There were these discussions. Some people were for the death penalty, some weren't. So it was a lively scene on the set of Deme Walking.